Johnny Monroe, and you are listening to the one and only Gina Peek on the Big Rock Show.
You're lost in the desert, headed for early decay.
I'm David Staple, Firewolf, and you're listening to the Big Rock Show with the lovely Gina Peek. So crank it up and break off the knob.
That's why I love you, cause you're so unholy.
Hi everybody, this is Rob Halford, the Metal God, with my metal girlfriend, Gina Peek, on the Big Rock Radio Show. Turn it up.
Welcome to Season 6 of The Big Rock Show, with your host, Gina Peek.
Oh my god, yes!
New episodes, new music, and new interviews. For more information, check out thebigrockshow.net.
Hello friends, and welcome to The Big Rock Show. Hailing from California by way of Georgia, up-and-coming metalists Brute Forcz are multifaceted headbangers. In addition to the band's Bob Kulick-produced EP entitled Kick-Ass Heavy Metal, two of the band's members are former pro wrestlers, Jammer, who handles vocals and bass, and his twin brother Slammer on drums. And rounding out the headbanging trio is guitarist Will Wallner. Jammer and Slammer have wrestled alongside Jake the Snake Roberts and Abdullah the Butcher, and won first tag team belts at Georgia All-Star Wrestling. The pair are also known for landing acting gigs, their latest in Adam Sandler's upcoming new film, Jack and Jill, out in theaters on November 11th, and also featuring Al Pacino and Katie Holmes. And joining me today is lead vocalist Jammer. I'll be playing a couple of tracks off Brute Forcz's debut EP, Kick-Ass Heavy Metal. The second I'll spin right after my chat with Jammer, it's called Sex Machine. So make sure you stick around. Jammer will be with us shortly, but first up is Leather and Chains, and it's by Brute Forcz.
Welcome to the Big Rock Show. We're going to party our tits off today. I think you know that. I know that. The American people know that. It's going to be a great program. So just go ahead and squeeze your girth and sit back and listen.
Well, we're back, and I've got Jammer on the phone with me. Hey, Jammer, welcome to the Big Rock Show. How's it going?
Well, I'm very good. Thanks for having me here. I appreciate it.
No problem. I've been catching a cold. I've got this huge frog in my throat, so if every now and again I clear my throat and cough a little bit, you'll have to excuse me, Jammer. I'm really sorry.
You're from Boston, though, so you're used to colder weather, right?
Yeah, well, you know what? Actually, the show is based in the States. I'm north of Toronto in Canada, so it's pretty cold here.
Okay. And I like your hockey team, but we know they suck all the time.
Hey. You cannot discuss Toronto Maple Leafs. They rule. And you cannot discuss what great weather you're having in California. Those two things are completely off topic, Jammer. Unless you tell me that it's raining and freezing in L.A. and you tell me that the Leafs rule, well, then we can talk.
I have a Leafs jersey, and it's about 74 degrees here, so... One out of two ain't bad.
No, that's not bad. So we can continue the interview then. Yeah, you're such a smart ass. So are you a hockey fan? Do you follow hockey?
I used to play a lot of hockey. I played semi-pro hockey for a minor league team. So I'm a big hockey fan, but I'm old school. I don't like the way it is now. It's too, I don't want to be a smart ass, but it's too candy ass now. You're not allowed to touch anybody. I like the old style.
I did too. I have to admit, I did too. And I mean, a lot of people who are just finding out about hockey now are trying to say, well, you know, there's no need for fighting. There's no room for fighting. But you know, that whole instigator rule, that's what caused the demise of fighting as far as I was concerned. They should never have taken that out.
Toronto had one of the greatest fighters ever that put butts in the seat, Dave Tiger Williams. So all that stuff about not being a sport or not drawing is wrong, because when Tiger Williams came to a stadium, people came to see him.
Oh.
Do you remember him?
Oh, God, yes. I remember him standing, I think it was in front of the Boston bench, and basically doing this and calling all the players out on the ice to fight with them. It was awesome.
Right.
Yeah, my favorite all time is Wendell Clark. I loved Wendell.
Wendell Clark's another guy.
Yeah.
He can never play in this league because they would restrict him so much.
Yeah, although if he played in this league, he'd probably, well, maybe not right now, still be playing, but his career would have been a little longer. I mean, his knees were done. In the last couple of years he played hockey, he played with braces on his knees because he couldn't handle it. Same with Bobby Orr, right? I mean, the whole reason Wayne Gretzky lasted as long as he did is because of the, quote, new NHL. If it had been back in the day, his knees would have been done, just like Bobby. They used to attack Bobby's knees specifically to injure him, to put him out.
Yeah, all these guys that retired that were great could still be playing, could have played an extra 5 years in this league, because we have Tammy Solani in about 5 years ago when he was playing for San Jose, before they switched these rules. He was all beat up. He was ready to retire, and then they made these new rules, and now he's got an extended career. So
yeah,
the real hockey fans know.
Yeah, I mean, there are some benefits to the way the game is played today. And I mean, the three deaths over the summer, especially for me, Wade Bielak, it was just a shock. So I'm not sure if that says anything about the way the NHL or the Players Association treats their players after they retire, whether there's just not enough out there for them, you know, to help gear them into a new way of life, a new profession. But it seems that the star players really aren't getting the star treatment when it's all said and done.
Right. No, you're probably, I'm surprised that I can actually talk hockey to a woman that knows what she's talking about. Because most women don't, so you're moving up the ladder on our scale there.
Well,
I'm just messing with you.
Hey, well, you know what? You've met the right girl, because I love hockey. I'm a hockey fanatic. Been to games, and I watch Hockey Night in Canada. I never miss that. Don Cherry, he's my all-time favorite. He rules.
He's great. If it helps me and my brother hate Montreal anyway, so that's for real.
Yay! My girlfriend's not going to like you guys now. She's a huge Montreal Canadiens fan. Boo! So, I think this is going to be a great interview. You sound awesome already. You sound like a lot of fun, and I love that. Now, I have to ask you this first, Jammer. How did two brothers, you and your twin brother Slammer, who are best known as professional wrestlers and who won the Georgia All-Star Wrestling Tag Team belts, decide to form a band called Brute Forcz just last year in 2010? How does that happen?
We actually had the band before. When we got out of high school, we always played a lot of sports, including hockey. But when we got out of high school, shortly after that, we wanted to start a band. We were living in Atlanta then, and we wanted to start a cover band and start playing because they've always been in us, and we never had the opportunity. So we had started the cover band, but we never found a singer. We kept looking for a singer. We had my brother on drums, me on bass, and a guitar player, and we could never find a singer. And then one day, we actually saw a wrestler doing a skit where he was singing. And my brother and I were saying, well, that guy can sing, and it sounds decent with music behind it. Maybe, you know, we can do something about that. And the very next day, we had a singer come over to audition for the band. And he said, I have a wide range of voice, but I can't do, for example, Killed by Death by Motorhead. And we were going, well, who's that? Because at that time, we really didn't know who Motorhead was, for example, because, you know, they don't play any videos like that. It was Atlanta. It was kind of, you know, quiet about heavy metal and stuff like that. So after he left, I put on Motorhead, and I said to myself, well, you know what? If Lemmy of Motorhead can take his voice and sing and make it fit around his music, and the wrestler can, then I will too. So then we decided to become a three-piece. And then that's how we started our band. We actually had a lot of gigs. We were playing a lot in Atlanta. And then that's when we actually had an opportunity to start wrestling that we couldn't refuse. So that's really when the band started and how it got started right then. We laid off when we wrestled. And then we kicked the band up last year in January for a long time. So I guess we took a long vacation break to do other things.
Right on. Okay, now Brute Forcz consists of you and your brother Slammer, of course, and also features guitarist Will Wallner. How did you guys find Will, and what does he bring to the band?
Okay, we found Will because when we wanted to start the band up again, I wanted to be a better guitar player. I wanted to learn to play guitar a little better so that when I wrote the songs, I could at least give my guitar player an example of what I wanted and then let him take it from that point. So I wanted to be a little better on guitar. So I went on to Craigslist, and I was looking for guitar teachers, and Will was the first guy that I came to. And I took a couple of lessons from him because I just wanted to learn some cover tunes and just, you know, get myself more proficient on the guitar. At the same time, he had just finished playing with a band that he was with. So I told him, look, my brother and I are going to start our band up. Would you like to be a guitar player with us? Because he was teaching me my own stuff, too, kind of refreshing me on that. And I said, you know, when you find something different, great. You can, you know, if you need to go, you can go. But during this time, we're going to be starting our band. We're going to be trying to play and get out there. Can you play with us? And he said, yes. So we've had him ever since, and we're very lucky. What Will brings to our band is a really good energy. He's a really good guitar player. I personally don't think he's got to the point. He has a lot of room still to grow, and that's on the negative. He really doesn't know his own boundaries. He's a really good, solid guitar player. He's a good rhythm player. He's a really good lead guitar player. And he just has a good look for us because we're bigger, we're long hair. We look metal. I'm not giving a shot to all the other bands. There's a lot of bands that are out now that don't even look metal. So he gives a good look to us. He gives a youthfulness to us. And he's just a really good person to be with. He's a real quiet guy, really easy to get along. So he's a good fit for our band. He's a good piece in that puzzle, which I really do believe that you have to have those team players if you want to be successful for a period of time. He's a good team player.
Right on. Okay. Now, Brute Forcz are based in California, but you and your twin brother Slammer are from Georgia originally, right?
Correct, Atlanta.
Atlanta, right. So what is it about California, besides the pretty ladies and the great weather, that has the band making Los Angeles their home base now, Jammer?
We moved out here to act. Once we had gotten out, as we were kind of leaving wrestling, we were actually getting into being actors, and we had been getting small parts in non-union movies and opportunities to do things in acting while we were in Atlanta. We had actually done a movie in Tennessee, and the lead actor was Joe Estevez, who is Charlie Sheen's uncle, Martin Sheen's twin brother. Right. And he told us that we had done a good job on the movie. You know, if you guys ever wanted to come to California, you know, I can kind of hook you up with my agency and you can take it from there.
Wow.
So we tried to do the acting thing being in Atlanta from California. They would send us parts to do, and we would have to tape them, videotape them, and then send them back, and it didn't work out, so we had to make a decision. So then we moved to L.A., and we moved to L.A. in 2003. We had some success in acting early. Last couple of years have been kind of slow for the business because of the economy and actor strikes, writer strikes. And then that's when we decided to kick the band in while we still had the opportunity to.
All right. Now, I love the name of the band. It's obviously a perfect fit for you guys. Who came up with it?
I think we came up with it together. Me and my brother were sitting around one day thinking, you know, there's that guy slammed him with Brute Forcz and things like that, and it just kind of clicked with us. So we were bigger guys. And when we actually wrestled, we would come out with songs like Metallica, Seek and Destroy, and things like that. And then we had to quit doing that, so we came out to our own music, and then all that developed. We were a heavy metal wrestling team, and we put all that together. We came up with the name Brute Forcz because we were just bigger guys, and that's usually, you know, how we wrestled. We took people and did things with Brute Forcz, so that's how we came up with the name, basically.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Cool name. No one has anything like it, so we thought it was cool.
Yeah. Now, Bob Kulick, who has worked with such renowned artists such as Kiss and Meatloaf, produced your debut EP entitled Kick-Ass Heavy Metal. How did the band hook up with Bob, and what did he bring to the table for Brute Forcz?
The way that we met Bob was we had been doing some recording with some of the producers around here, and we couldn't find anybody that could produce our music the way we wanted it to. Every time we would do a song, when the finished product came out, we were really disappointed. And that's what happens when you use Craigslist as opposed to being in that circle where Bob's at. There's a huge difference.
Yeah.
We were just really disappointed. We were in the gym one day working out, and we would see this guy come back and forth every other day. He'd be in there with us, and he'd go back and forth, and we were thinking to ourselves, who is that guy? He looks very familiar to us. And then he came by us one time, and we recognized it was Bruce Kulick of Kiss.
Right.
And we were huge Kiss fans, so we immediately got off what we were doing. And it was kind of funny. We walked over to him and kind of cornered him into a corner, and he had this look on his face like, hey, what are these two big gorillas coming after me for? I didn't do anything. He had a look on his face like, you know, what's going on here? And we told him that we were fans of Kiss and that we had been professional wrestlers and we acted a bit, but we were trying to get our band going again, and we were having difficulty finding someone that could produce it to be metal. So he said, anybody around here? I took a shot. Do you know anybody around here that may be able to do metal and do a song as really as a good old style heavy metal type? And he goes, yeah, my brother, I'll give him your number. You give me your number, I'll have him call you. So the next day we got a call from Bob, and we set up a meeting to go meet him and went to a studio. And when you first go there, you're really blown away, especially us, because we're not, you know, we're new to this kind of industry as far as that level.
Right.
You walk in there, the gold records all over the wall and guitars and amps and everything. And we talked to him for about an hour, just strictly about wrestling, and then we got into what he could do to help us. Bob's a really, really good guy. He's a true professional, and you don't know that until you work with him. But when you work with the other people that we have, and then you work with Bob, you realize that you're thankful that you're able to work with someone like him. He's from New York, so he has a dry kind of comic attitude, so you got to get used to him. But we're used to giving it back because we're wrestlers, so we had a good fit. He really helped us develop our style more. He made each one of us play better, took us to another level, helped develop my voice, and he really helped us develop Brute Forcz, because what you hear now is not what it was 6 months before that point, and that was because Bob really helped us. And we really hope that we're fortunate enough to work with Bob from this point on. I don't know if it'll be like that or not, but if we have an opportunity, we definitely want to work with him, because we really do love him, and he's a good, really good guy and a great producer.
That's awesome. And who does most of the writing in the band, Jammer, or is that more of a collaboration between all three of you?
It's just usually me and my brother.
Oh, really? And what sorts of things do you guys like to write about?
Why you laugh? if you look at our songs, mainly sex, kicking ass, having a good time, raising hell, that kind of thing.
Yeah, right on. I love that.
Every once in a while, we'll write about something different, like sex, but usually it's old school stuff, stuff that makes people just want to bang their head and raise hell.
Yeah, right on. And sex.
Yes. I'll write something about hockey, maybe. We'll see about that.
Oh, yes, do that. And then make sure you put dedicated to Tina Peak of the Big Rock Show on it.
I will. I'll think about doing that right now, as a matter of fact. Good idea, Tina. Thanks.
All right. Now, Kick-Ass Heavy Metal consists of four tracks. I know it's new. It was recently released on July 25th, and it's a great disc. But I was curious if the band has any plans to put out a full-length album at some point, Jammer.
Thanks for the compliment. Yeah, we do. We have plenty of songs. We just really wanted to put out four songs to get ourselves known out there, to throw it out there and see how the response would be, and that's why we did that. We have plans to, whenever it's best for us, we'll put out a full album, a full CD, and that may be shortly before the end of the year or maybe sometime after the first of the year, but we have material. We're just kind of waiting for the right direction from the people that we work with to see when it needs to be done. But we're ready to go whenever that needs to be done.
Oh, that's awesome. So you guys have been writing more songs. Have you completed all the songs for another disc?
Yeah, when we play a show, we don't just play four songs.
Well,
we
no, of course not.
Worth of material.
Right.
So I think it's kind of deceiving because everybody asks that question where they kind of seem like, you guys only have four songs. But we played 40 shows last year in Southern California. We have a full hour's worth of material.
Right on.
We already have it done. It's ready to go.
All right. Well, then let me ask you this. Have there been any discussions yet about putting out an official video in the near future?
We're talking about that. This business is so hard because if you do one thing, then somebody wants something else. And if you do those two things, then someone wants something else. So we're trying to just do what's best to help get us out there. And I think the best thing for us right now, we've thought about doing a video, but the next step for us as Brute Forcz is to get out and tour
right,
so that people can see us and we can get our name out there a little better. So that's the next step for us.
All right. For fans tuning in today, Jammer, how would you guys describe the sound and music of Brute Forcz?
Well, I just call it heavy metal. A lot of people, though, say it's classic 80s heavy metal, and we're not, we're happy about that. That's a compliment to us because that style of metal, that 80s classic is still the best sound out there. All the older bands that played during that period, like Priest and Motley Crue and Wasp and AC/DC,
yeah,
all those bands are still playing. They're very popular, Iron Maiden. So I would just call it regular good old heavy metal, but if you want to call it 80s style metal, you can do that. We're just, our motto is big, thick, and in your face, and that's how our music is. We just come out blasting good leads, good songs, and let it go at that.
Okay, fair enough. And for those of us who haven't seen the band perform live yet, what could we expect at a Brute Forcz gig?
Well, just to go back to your other question for a second, we're not called the Poindexters, we're called Brute Forcz, so that's how our music is. Well, we're just good musically as far as metal. We just come out blasting, and then we tune it up from there. We have a lot of energy in our music, so our fans, people that go to our shows, like it for that. And they can just expect a really good head-banging experience. We just come out, like I mentioned, kicking ass and take it up from that point. So it's just good. If you like metal the way it used to be or it's lacking right now, then you'll like what you hear because we're just a good metal band. It's I really call it similar to Motorhead. So if you like Motorhead, you would like us.
All right. Now, you and Slammer, as we talked about earlier, you've had quite a bit of success with acting, including national commercials for IBM and Budweiser, And recently you finished work for Adam Sandler's latest movie called Jack and Jill. I mean, I love Adam Sandler. So how did you guys get into the whole thing with Adam? How did that come about?
Well, we have an agent, a manager, and we got an audition to audition for that movie. And to be honest with you, at first, we really didn't want to go.
Really?
Sometimes you go on these auditions and you just get a feeling that this isn't going to be your audition. For example, we always get auditions for bikers, but we're not the normal, we don't look like the tough biker guys, even though we're big and have long hair. You know, we look like the Hollywood bikers. So we went to the audition. As we walked in, Adam Sandler was right there at the audition. We were freaking out because that's the first, you know, really big star that we have auditioned for. He was there making the decision. So we were all fired up. He asked for a picture. We were goofing around with him. We were talking about his movie, Happy Gilmore. Had to talk again with Boston Bruin. But he asked us to do improv, and we were good at that. Since we were wrestlers, we have to be good at improv. We did a good job, good enough to be in the movie. And as a matter of fact, we found out just the other day, last week, because we didn't know if we'd be on the cutting room floor or not, because when you do a part, sometimes you'll get paid to do the part, but you won't be in the movie, they'll cut you out.
Right.
And we just found out the other day that he actually called my brother to make sure they had the correct spelling for his name on the credits. So I'm assuming that we did make it on the screen, so we're very happy about that.
Yay, congratulations.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. I don't believe anything until I actually see it, so. But just in case no one ever sees it, we actually did do a whole day with Adam Sandler, and it was pretty good. Adam Sandler's a really great guy, too. You mentioned you like him. He's a really super nice guy, and he's not what you would think of as a typical Hollywood kind of guy. He's just very nice and polite and friendly, and it's a pleasure to work with someone like that.
And what roles did you and Slammer have in Jack and Jill?
Well, this movie is about twins, and he plays his own twin sister, and now he can't get rid of her, so it was for twins. So we would just give some of our stories of growing up as twins, what happened sometimes when we would, just go through life and things like that. I think he's going to, they made us do some kind of funny dance, so I think they're going to actually put that in the movie. And it's going to be embarrassing if you see that, so we'll have to wait. I'm kind of scared, but I still want to be in the movie, so I got to take the good with the bad.
Oh, yeah, of course. And it's all in good fun. I mean, my God, it's an Adam Sandler movie. It's all about laughter. I love his movies for that. All right, now I'm going to ask you something. If someone said to you, you have to pick one or the other, acting, professional wrestling, or being in Brute Forcz, what would you say to them? Would you be able to choose?
Oh, yeah. We're in the band for real. We've always wanted to be in the band. We've always been metalheads. We just took a different direction to get to this point. But we want to push our band. We want to be in our band. We want to carry a heavy metal mantra. We don't have a problem with that. We don't mind carrying the banner for that if that's what it comes down to. We're really disappointed. We're metal fans. We're music fans in general, but we're really heavy metal fans first. And as fans, we're really disappointed in the music the last 10 years. To us, it's pretty sorry. No disrespect to a couple bands out there, but it's not really as good as we used to have it when we were growing up. So we want to push the band. We're going to be in the band, and the band's the first priority for us. It always has been. Again, it's just that we had to take a different road to get to that point. I'm sure you know a lot about this business. You got to pay your dues. You got to, the cost, it's not what it used to be. You have to do a lot of work. You have to spend a lot of money. You have to put yourself in a position to get looked at. So if it wouldn't be for people like yourself, we wouldn't have an opportunity. So we do thank you for that, too.
Aw, well, thank you. I'm very flattered. That's very nice of you to say that. All right, now, Jammer, I thought now would be a good time to throw out some links. Is there anything you want to get out there today, like a website or Facebook, Reverb Nation?
Well, you can go to our Facebook. It's spelled Brute Forcz, BRUTEFORC, Z as in zebra. You can also go to our MySpace page. We'll have our website up in about, we'll have a brand new website up in about 2 weeks.
Cool.
You can go to either our MySpace or our Facebook right now. And then you can buy our songs on iTunes or CD Baby or any of the national outlets that are out there. Or you can also go to our site and purchase them. We also have T-shirts that are about ready to, for sale. They're actually on our site. We just haven't set them up to be sold yet, but we're getting the whole thing, we're getting the whole program done here.
All right, cool. Now let me ask you this. The band aren't signed yet. Are the band actively pursuing label support? Is that something that you guys would like, or have you decided that you'd rather stay indie?
No, we're trying to do anything we can to get signed. That's the whole goal. We need the help financially to get us out there, but we're doing anything that we can do to have anything positive happen to us. So whatever it takes, we're willing to do it. So, you know, we already have a couple big things in the works, but I don't like to say anything until it actually happens because I like to jinx myself, and then I don't want to say, hey, we're doing this with these guys, and it all falls apart. So we're actually trying to get on a tour with a couple of bigger bands, at the beginning of next year. And if we're able to get on one of those, if we're fortunate enough to be able to work the deal out, it will really help throw us onto the national spotlight. That's the goal for us right now.
Wow. That sounds exciting. I can't wait to hear it.
Yeah, we want to come to Canada, too. Bad.
Oh, really? Oh, well, so be there. All right, now the band's first gig was in Tarzana, California on January 28th of 2010. And since then, Brute Forcz have shared the stage with Wasp, Ballet Guns, the Michael Schenker Group, Loudness, Y&T, and a lot more, as well as headlining your own gig at the House of Blues. So besides this big thing that you're working on, which is all secretive, of course, are there any other upcoming gigs you can tell us about, or the band working on something else that you can share with us yet?
Yeah, we're also trying to get booked beginning of next year, the early part of next year. We're working to see about getting booked on the Monster Truck Jams.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, they're coming out to the West Coast. They're in L.A. a couple of dates, Anaheim, San Diego, and Sacramento, and then their finals is in the Las Vegas in March. And we're working to try to get booked on multiple shows doing the Monster Truck Jams.
That's awesome.
Yeah, that'd be huge for us. It's a huge crowd.
Mm-hmm.
It's all kind of crowd, rowdy, raising hell kind of group.
Yeah, right on. Jammer, is there anything else that you'd like to add that I didn't ask you today? Or do you have any messages for your fans out there or the folks tuning in here today?
Well, we'd like to get the Canadian fans to help us so we can actually come to Canada, because we've never been and we really want to go. And we're big fans of Bitchin' Kitchen and Nadia G. And she is Canadian. You ever seen her show before?
No.
She's Canadian. It comes from Canada. It's called Bitchin' Kitchen. And she's a rock heavy metal cook.
Oh, really?
We worked on to Canada real bad. Well, no, we just like to thank our friends and family for hanging in there with us. And any new fans, just, you know, we're going to be touring soon. Come out. You'll have a good time, we promise. And again, we do like to thank people like yourself, Tina, because without people like you, the Big Rock Show, helping us out, bands like us being able to get our form out there, we wouldn't have a shot. So we really want to thank you again.
No problem.
If anybody gives you a hard time, just let us know. We'll go Dave Tiger Williams on them, all right?
All right, that's a deal. Well, you know what? Thank you so much for chatting today, Jammer. It was a lot of fun. Best of luck with Kick-Ass Heavy Metal, and I'm wishing Brute Forcz much success.
Thanks a lot. We appreciate you. Have a good day, okay? If I die, bury me in leather and chains. Hey, this is Jammer from the heavy metal band Brute Forcz, and this is PMP at the Big Rock Show, kicking some serious booty. In leather and chains,
yeah. The Big Rock Show. New music, interviews, and much more. Find us at thebigrockshow.net or on Facebook. Facebook.com, The Big Rock Show. The Big Rock Show, baby. Oh, yeah.